The data science and advanced analytics team really focuses on the fundamental problem of how we use data in healthcare. They say the average complex medical decision considers hundreds of parameters. So things like social history, family history, vital signs, symptoms, laboratory values, medical imaging results, all that stuff goes in our heads and we make a diagnosis. And sometimes, you know, we're not very good at it. Can we use machines? Can we use AI to help us process all of that information rapidly and efficiently to help us make better decisions, which will translate into better outcomes for patients and a more efficient healthcare system? When clinicians come to us, they usually are struggling with problems day in and day out. They really understand what the issues are. They understand their workflows, what matters, what doesn't matter. They're the ones we really focus on. They define the problems that we work on, but we also engage them fully into the process.
So the ChartWatch project started at Unity Health when we asked patients, clinicians, hospital leaders, what would you want to use artificial intelligence for? If you could predict one thing that AI would tell you, what should that be? And one of the leading priorities of everyone was to be able to predict in advance which patients might become so sick in hospital that they need ICU or might die.
What the model does is it takes as input all of the patient's medical history, so demographics, labs, vitals, and so on. It'll look at that, and it'll also look at the interaction between those various inputs, as well as how some of these data are changing over time. So the model will take all of that into account and will basically categorize each patient within our risk groups for deterioration. So each patient will be categorized as being low risk or medium risk or high risk for deterioration.
If I were patients, I would be so relieved to know that we have this kind of system. Because sometimes, you know, we're so busy and nursing staff, they look after up to 6 patients. So sometimes the care can be a little bit delayed. So when patient gets a high alert, they're going to be assessed by senior staff right away. And also they're going to have a quite close monitoring by nursing staff. So they check on them every 1 to 2 hours.
Team lead, usually Alice, received a high chart watch alert. And then she would inform the primary nurse, which is I'm the bedside nurse as well. And then I would closely monitor the patient, prioritize high alert versus the stable ones, and then do necessary interventions as needed.
And then every time I hear the alarm, I just tell the nurses, whoever has the patient, and then also inform the doctor. From the first time it's been used, I could only remember one transfer to ICU.
It's one thing to build an AI model, but to have it actually being used is awesome.
I think and I hope that AI will have a very profound impact on our patients. Some of those benefits will really be a direct byproduct from the changes that will happen to our providers. Hopefully with reduced administrative burden on our providers, they will have more time to spend with our patients and really focus on the patient needs. I hope that AI will be able to distill the just incredible amounts of information that's really coming at our clinicians, distill it into important components and really bring their clinical judgment to the forefront.